Hello and welcome to this demo. Microsoft have released a new grid control, and in this presentation we're going to have a look at four of those enhancements, including infinite scrolling, how you can add color coding for option sets, how you can edit straight from a grid. But first of all, we're going to have a look at the new option to show expandable grids for related records. With the new Power Apps grid control enabled, you see here next to these accounts there's an expand button. We can just click there and see the opportunities. You can set this up for other related items as well. Once a view has been expanded, you can then see that you can interact with that opportunity simply by selecting it as normal. This view can be enabled to perform this way for other entities. So let's have a look at this now under the All Opportunities view. This has been configured to allow us to view all of the products on an opportunity when that particular opportunity is expanded. You can see an opportunity here for a possible order. We can then click on there and then see all of the products that are enabled for it. One of the most powerful functions of the new grid feature is the infinite scrolling. Typically, you'd be restricted to 250 records per page. You can see here all 682 of the contacts in the database available, and if we scroll down, you'll simply see all of those contacts loading. You can see that that can be a considerable time saving. You don't have to keep clicking to get to the next page. If we wanted to, we could again sort this by a specific column, in this case here, the full name, and then you'll see that you've got this alphabetical display. So if we wanted to jump to, for example, a list of contacts beginning with letter F, again, we can just click over to them and it will take us to those records. The new grids function will allow you to have color coding where you have option sets displayed in a view. Here you can see this rating where people have selected from warm, hot or cold. You can see that displayed by these different colors on this view. We could also use this color coding on other record types such as cases. You can see here on the right hand side, you can see the color coding for the status reason. We can now see the in progress, the researching, and the email and phone. The color codes that you see displayed here can be edited by going to make.powerapps.com, selecting the relevant table, and then selecting the field that's marked as a choice. If you then select this option here to edit choice, you can then see all of the colors displayed next to the values. And that's how you can edit the color codes that are displayed on the Power Apps grid control. You can also edit items directly from the view with this new control switched on. So let's say I just wanted to add in a bit of further detail. You can see that I can add this in to one item in the list. And again, I could update the next one in the list like so. To set up the Power Apps grid control, select the settings here. Select Advanced Settings. Select the drop down and customizations, customize the system, expand entities and select the relevant entity. We can then select controls. You'll then see the option here to add the control for the Power Apps grid control. We can then select the item. As we scroll down, you'll see the different items that we can add in, such as enabling editing, enabling filtering, enabling the jump bar for the alphabet at the bottom of the screen, and enabling the option set colors. To be able to view child records on the view, just select this item here where it says child items, select configure property. We can then select the entity that we'd like to see. In this case here, going to set this up so as we can view opportunities. We can then select the default view that's going to show when expanded. And in this case here, I'm going to select all opportunities. We'll then select OK. We can then select this item here. Now this shows how the accounts that are displayed in the view relate to the relevant opportunities. And we're going to set this up to show that these accounts are the parent account for the opportunity. So you can now see in the list here, we've got this record, parent account ID. We can select this, select OK, save, then publish. And these are the ways that we can configure the new Power Apps grid control within Dynamics 365.